We got to talk about T.I. He was just overseas and got arrested. I'm like, brother, aren't you tired of getting arrested? That's what I'm just, I guess,
it's
at this point, he's just used to it at this point. I don't know. We have some video of him explaining what went down. Listen to this and then we'll discuss.
So I'm locked up now. I'm obviously not supposed to have my phone as I'm biking, and because the policeman ran into me and broke his his rear view, you know.
Don't you have N?
Huh?
They're gonna take it?
Yes, I'm getting it right now. I'm trying to get it from him right now. And because I didn't have my passport on me. I don't know. It'll be fine. But he was extremely upset. I was having a great time. Still, I'm still not upset. I'm having a phenomenal time.
I think I know what is causing him to have a great time. He looks like he was partaking in some of those Amsterdam activities over there, if you know what I mean. But at least he's in good spirits as he's sitting in a jail cell. But he goes on to talk about how they didn't put him in handcuffs, they didn't search him, and he liked the treatment that he received from them. Put him in the cop car, just took him to jail nicely. So I was like, we could use some of that over here these days.
It is interesting that his Instagram handle is like Troubleman Troubleman31 or something like that. I mean, it is interesting, you know, you put that out in the universe, you get caught up in everything everywhere you go sometimes.
Yeah, and I think sometimes it was, especially when he was coming up as a rapper, it was part of that whole aura of the bad boy, you know, you wanted to portray that to help sales and different things like that. But he's a father now. He's older now. It's time to go ahead and start behaving yourself, brother. But
one would hope.
Yeah, exactly.
One
but
would help.
You know, you want to be safe too. Driving around on a scooter or a motorcycle with a cell phone is not necessarily the safest thing to do either. So
yeah, he was on his phone. We don't know exactly how everything, A to B, B to C, and how it played out. But we know he was on his phone, and you're not supposed to be on your phone while on your bike in Amsterdam. And so, you know, gets into some type of accident, and there he is, as we saw in the jail cell. So.
But it is easy to see how something like this in his defense could happen, especially if you're in Amsterdam, you're, you know, Instagram and tweeting like, oh, look at me, I'm riding around. You know,
I mean, even in the jail cell, he's doing an Instagram story. Do you know that my phone would be far away? I'm in a different country. I don't have my passport. I think I would put my phone away and just obey the authorities until it all cleared up. Then when I got out, if I'm T.I., then I might say something to the people, right?
Yeah, no, I'm doing it right now. Like I told you, he was partaking. I'm just saying.
Maybe it was to protect himself.
Yeah,
maybe it was to protect
evidence.
Himself.
But he didn't seem to feel threatened. He was having a good time. Yeah. They didn't, you know, use force when they took him in. And also, he had a wad of cash. He said he had to call somebody to make bail because they weren't accepting cash. Brother, why are you carrying that much cash around with you? It was literally a wad of cash. I guess when you're T.I., you can do things like that, but just be careful. That's all I'm saying.
Be careful. Well, we hope you get back safely if you do want to get back.
Right.
You know, I don't know if you do, but if you do want to get back to the United States, we hope you get here safely.
Rubber band man. All right.
And, you know, speaking of protecting oneself, Sharon Stone was talking about how she has asked for the set of where she works. Of course, you know, Hollywood actress there. Saying that in Atlanta for her next project, she's saying everyone needs to be fully vaccinated. And that's something where she's made this request and says that it may cost her her job.
And that's ridiculous. A lot of people think she's being overbearing. She's putting in all these stipulations and being a diva. No, she wants to save her life, and she wants to protect those that are also working with her. Sean Penn made the same request, and he didn't have any pushback, but then she does it, and this happens. And Will Smith's new movie, Emancipation, was just put on hold because of COVID.
Yeah.
Several people on the set tested positive, and now they don't know when they're going to be back up. Presumably, they're going to have to wait 10 days before they can start production again. So I think she's smart by saying this. You know, she's a star. It can't go on without her. Mm-hmm. If she gets sick, if she gets hospitalized, then they're in big trouble. The same with the director. So I don't see it as a problem. Maybe they need to film in New York and she'll get more support in New York.
It's possible. You know, where you live right now, where you work right now can make all the difference. She said, quote, ridiculous, we should have to go to work where we are not safe to work. And look, sometimes it takes that voice. And look, she's a power player, Sharon Stone. And sometimes it takes that voice to then lead others to say, okay, this is unacceptable. Yeah. We've got to do this across the board.
I'm sure sure she's not the only one that doesn't feel safe.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Right.